Hi again, my dear IGCSE students. Everywhere, this is the second video to continue with solving triangles. As we finished introduction for what are we doing in this chapter, so we'll be doing the first case, solving right triangles. And as we said, solving means we are finding unknown sides or angles. First case, as we said, right triangles. If we are given two sides in a right angle triangle, to find the third, I use as a student Pythagoras theorem. Let's explain how do you use Pythagoras theorem and what does it mean. In words, we are not interested to write it in words because we can explain it from the triangle here. This is a right angle triangle. Because this is a right angle, like obviously we are see here. We call A and B, as explained here in words, the legs of the triangle, the legs. And the opposite side, which is the longest side, always is the longest side in the triangle, that is opposite to the right angle, that is called the hypotenuse of the triangle. C is called the hypotenuse of the triangle. So, if the triangle is right angle triangle, Pythagoras states the sum of the squares of the legs of the triangle is equal to the square of the hypotenuse. Again, the square of the hypotenuse of a right angle triangle is equal to the sum of the squares of the legs of the triangle. So in symbols as equation, A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared, where A and B are called the legs of the triangle. The legs of the triangle. And C is called the hypotenuse of the triangle. Let's see by examples how the question comes on this simple case. So this is the first example, part A. We are given this triangle, the length as shown, and the sides are labeled. This is 5 centimeters long, this is 12 centimeter, and this labeled with C. This question means, or asks, find C. So since C is the hypotenuse of this triangle, so you write C squared, applying Pythagoras theorem, C squared is equal to 5 squared plus 12 squared. By calculating this, according to our abilities, by calculator, but mentally, C squared is equal to 25 plus 144 equals 169. We are finding C, my dear students, here, C, so a square root. We do squaring root both sides, getting the square root of 169, which is 13 centimeters. If we are given another triangle like this, like this case or this form, this is the right angle, like you see here. So this is the hypotenuse of the triangle. So don't judge the shape as it is. Most of times we draw the triangles in this case, but if it's drawn like this, I have to label and we know, recognize the sides, especially the hypotenuse in this case. To not do algebraic mistake here, to not do right and calculate wrong side in the future. So this is the hypotenuse. A is one of the sides or legs. 6 is one of the sides of the right angle. So we write the same. A squared plus 6 squared is equal to 10 squared. By calculating now or solving this equation for A, so A squared equals 10 squared, which is 100, minus 36, which is 64. So A squared equals 64. By a squaring root, you will get A is equal to 8. A is equal to 8. I think this is simple and easy. Because of that, I was a little bit fast, because this is common topic, you took it before. If the students in the IGs like they didn't take it yet, so this is the chance to understand the introduction of right angle triangles. In the next video now, we'll be continuing solving right angle triangles with case 2. If we are not given two sides, that Pythagoras will fail to solve or to apply this triangle. This is our main objective as core students. For extended students or the higher level in Excel, we have to solve non-right angle triangles using sine and cosine rule. This is that we are calling trigonometry, which is coming in the next videos. All right. I hope all understood this in the speed that we did. See you in the next, and shall hear from us in the next videos. All right.